Get ready for the next battle. Thank you.
Daddy's back, you bitches!
Hello, you are!
Daddy's back, you bitches! Hello, you
are!
Dave, come on!
Nero!
Come on!
Nico, what are you doing?
Dave is not coming.
Ignore him! Come on, we gotta get this thing ready before we talk. Let's go! Here, pass me that.
What you going to do?
I might come back on board, or I might try to make a go of it. Like they say, it is the land of opportunity. I always wanted to make it big, own a nice place, get a dog, a house, live the dream.
Like my cousin.
Oh yeah?
Yes, he's got a lot. House, women, cars, parties. He writes me these wild emails, and after I got into trouble, I thought maybe, then I got this gig, and I spent the next 7 months with you fine people, and I forget. After the war finished, I couldn't get a job. Nobody could. So I did some dumb things, got involved with some idiots.
Ah, we all do dumb things. That's what makes us human.
Could be.
Like us does.
welcome. You never had two women at once. Four cheats, titties to be playing with. Mr. Samda, Giovanni, we'll teach you your life, Giovanni.
The mongo de casio, die mom.
Cousin, it's been too long. You should have come out earlier. Think of all the girls you've been missing out on.
Our country has women too.
Yes, but only locals. Here we have whites, black, the Puerto Ricans and the Asians, Europeans on vacation, scared Canadians, bored housewives from the Midwest. Every possible choice. The city is like a big Uder milk and ice cream shop. 36 flavors of titty. Half beach is a little corner of Eastern Europe.
Kakoshamamsma. Half beach next to the docks. Immigrants here do not make it very far from the boats they come in on.
No, everyone seems happy where they are. It reminds them of the Black Sea or something. People leave home to hang around the people they ran away from. Well, Juno, it's just temporary for us, though. Our sights are set for the top mansions in Virtual. Penthouse in our country, a model on each arm. Me and my cousin Nico, rulers of the world.
What happens this season on Medicaid Me? What starts out as a simple kid getting a sweater escalates into a full-scale terrorist attack on the city. Luckily, the doctors of St. Judas General Hospital are ready.
Bob, you're drunk, and we've got to save some kids' lives.
That's because I love you, Karen.
That's original. I'm never going to win an Emmy if you don't start writing better scripts.
In the next episode, a patient wakes up and discovers he's a polygamist.
Oh, and Karen, I've got some serious news. You are 8 months pregnant.
But I'm gay.
Exactly.
Medicaid Me. Hospitals get real. This season, Jerry botches a home vasectomy. Carrie returns to the ER to meet the woman she killed 3 seasons ago. Jeremy comes back from Africa to discover he's wanted for murder. And lots of people die. Medicaid Me. It's a relaxing home entertainment drama for the whole family. Thursday nights at 9, 8 Central on CCC.
It's a Russian bomb extravaganza!
This is Vladivostok FM!
Привіт, Liberty City! Що, голова болить? Не допили чи перепили? Проблеми з газом? Кефірчика? На роботу! Бігом!
А що це за парня, котором тесні шори? Вишли на то вирозбірять любого пилипор. Всі говорять, ну, його кулак болит. А то із кого там дано для драки і шипов. Нам будет страху на майдон, парнішка свой в рубаху б'єт пах. Буде брати, тим, хто місяць і жупах. Бо ми ж урод, і місяць понад 90. І стоки во ребята збігать сам раза не прост. Промах льот, і удар жорсткий. Так то же он, там ще за новий чемпіон. Та рожон, тот, на котором всі вдруг.
Thank you. and no one gets hurt. Go! Open the door! You'll get worse than hurt! Hey! Hey! Come on! Come on! Come on!
Don't do any crap!
Let's go! Shut up! Shut the fuck up! Come on! In the back! Come on! Come on!
Der Frischling, Sir.
Also, was ist Soap überhaupt für ein Name?
Desto mehr bleibt gleich. Grenzen ändern sich, neue Mitspieler erscheinen, aber Macht findet immer einen Ort. haben mit den Rossen gekämpft und geblutet. War eigentlich klar, dass sie uns dafür hassen. Die Geschichte wird von Siegern geschrieben. Und ich dachte, wie wären das? Schaltet man einen Feind aus, finden sie einen noch schlimmeren Ersatz. Orte ändern sich. Der Grund, das Ziel. Feinde von gestern sind die Rekruten von heute. Beten wir, dass sie sich nicht plötzlich entscheiden, dich zu hassen und die Seite zu wechseln. Jeden Tag die alte Leier. Sie wissen, was ich suche, Sergeant Foley. Halten Sie die Augen offen.
Eine neue Gruppe geht durch die Grube, Sir. Ich schicke Ihnen den Besten.
Willkommen zu Abdrücken für Anfänger. Freund Allen gibt uns jetzt eine kleine Vorführung und zeigt uns, wie das gemacht wird. Nicht so ungut. Aber ich sehe schon jede Menge Leute hier aus der Hüfte feuern und zieh das um sich mal an. So verfehlt man nicht nur sämtliche Ziele, sondern das sieht auch scheiße aus. Private Allen, zeigen Sie ihnen, wovon ich rede. Nehmen Sie die Waffe vom Tisch und feuern Sie auf die Ziele hinter Ihnen. Nehmen Sie die Waffe vom Tisch und feuern Sie auf die Ziele hinter Ihnen.
Thank you. Tag.
A quick warm-up, shall we? Check the Soliton radar on the upper right and head to the point marked on the display. You can jump over obstacles, but the ninja run will get you across them more quickly and easily.
Tower, do you read? Shit, comms are down.
Thank you.
Die wegzwemmen.
Wie has come to?
V has come to.
After the end of World War II, the world was split into two, East and West. This marked the beginning of the era called the Cold War.
Soviet airspace.
20 minutes to drop off.
Commencing internal depressurization. Equipment check. Arm main parachute.
All right. You ready to go?
Drop zone still showing a high pressure mass. Cav okay.
Good. We've got high visibility.
Cigar. Connecting oxygen hose to interior connector. Put on your mask. Does this panty waist know what he's doing?
Approaching release point.
10 minutes to drop off.
Hey, are you deaf?
He said put out the cigar and put on your mask.
Depressurization complete.
Checking oxygen supply.
6 minutes to drop off. Opening rear hatch.
I've got some important news. The head of the CIA has finally given us the green light for the virtuous mission.
Virtual mission?
No, the virtuous mission. The future of our Fox unit depends on it. If it succeeds, we'll be officially organized into a unit.
Virtuous mission? Sounds like some kind of initiation ritual.
You know, don't get cocky. This isn't a training op.
Right. So what exactly is this wonderful mission?
Well, about 2 years ago, a certain Soviet scientist requested asylum in the West through one of our moles. His name is Nikolai Stepanovich Sokolov. He's head of the OKB-754 Design Bureau, one of the Soviet's top-secret weapon research facilities, and the East's foremost expert on weapons development.
Sokolov? Isn't he that famous rocket scientist?
The very same. On April the 12th, 1961, the Soviets achieved the first manned spaceflight in history.
The Earth was blue, but there was no God.
Well spoken. The rocket that carried Yuri Gagarin to orbit was the A-1, known as the Vostok rocket. Sokolov is said to be the man most responsible for the multi-engine cluster used in that rocket. After Gagarin's flight, Sokolov left rocket development to become the head of the newly established design bureau.
From a lowly technician to head of a design bureau, that's quite a success story. So why'd he want to defect?
It seems he'd become afraid of his own creations.
Afraid?
Call it a crisis of conscience.
And for that, he left his country and his family behind and went over the fence?
Not exactly. One of his conditions was that his family was also to be taken safely to the west. We used a mole to get the family out first and succeeded in sneaking Sokolov over the Berlin Wall shortly afterwards. I was the one who conducted the operation.
The security on the eastern side was still full of holes back then. Then what?
We got Sokolov over in one piece, but the whole ordeal had left him exhausted, and we checked him into a hospital in West Berlin. It took him 2 weeks and more than 600 miles to get from the research facility in the Soviet Union to Berlin. He was in no condition to say anything coherent. And it was only a week later that we had something much bigger on our hands.
The Cuban Missile Crisis.
October the 16th, 1962, President Kennedy received word that the Soviets were in the process of deploying intermediate-range ballistic missiles in Cuba. The President demanded that the Soviets dismantle and remove the missiles. At the same time, he announced a naval blockade to prevent further missile shipments from reaching Cuba. But the Soviets didn't back down, instead placing their armed forces on secondary alert. Soviet transport ships carrying missiles continued on course towards Cuba. U.S. and Soviet forces went on alert for an all-out nuclear war. Frantic negotiations were conducted through the UN's Emergency Security Council and unofficial channels to end the hair-trigger standoff. Finally, on October the 28th, the Soviet Union agreed to remove its missiles from Cuba. And so the world avoided a nuclear holocaust. But in order to get the Soviets to pull their missiles out, we had to make a deal.
You mean the one where the U.S. agreed to remove its IRBMs from Turkey?
No. The Jupiter IRBMs deployed in Turkey were obsolete, and we were going to get rid of them anyway. They had no strategic value whatsoever to either the U.S. or the Russians. The Turkey deal was a ruse, a cover story that was fed to the other intelligence agencies around the world.
So what did the Russians really want?
Sokolov. They wanted us to return Sokolov.
You mean the Soviets pulled out of Cuba just to get their hands on Sokolov?
That's right.
What the hell was he working on?
At the time, we had no idea. We were running out of time. It was either give up Sokolov or risk full-scale nuclear war. In the end, we had no choice. President Kennedy gave in to Khrushchev's demand. The next day, I got Sokolov out of the hospital, handed him over to agents on the eastern side. Sokolov kept on screaming, "Save me," until he disappeared from my sight. Then a month ago, we received some new information from one of our moles.
About Sokolov?
Yes. He was taken back to the research facility and forced to continue working on the weapon in question under KGB supervision. What's more, it's on the verge of completion.
So what kind of weapon is it? Something to do with space rockets?
No. Missiles.
Same technology.
I guess you're right. We don't know the details, but it appears to be a new kind of nuclear device. For half a year now, the Soviets have been conducting frequent nuclear tests at Semipalatinsk.
Something to do with the weapon, I assume.
We're talking about a secret weapon so big that Khrushchev was ready to pull out of Cuba to get it back.
Is Sokolov still in the facility?
No. According to our intelligence, he's in Selenoyarsk, a place in the mountains about 3 miles to the west that's known as the Virgin Cliffs.
The Virgin Cliffs? Nice name for a virtuous mission.
They moved him there just recently.
Why?
Apparently, they're conducting a field test of the weapon, but it's our best chance to get him back. This mission would never have been possible if he was still in the research facility. This is our last chance. Sokolov must have known that, too, when he contacted us.
mission is to infiltrate Selino-Yask in the Soviet mountains, ensure the safety of Sokolov, and bring him back to the West. If we don't get Sokolov back before that weapon is complete, we'll be facing a major crisis. The clock is ticking. Once we've confirmed the rescue of Sokolov, stand by at the recovery point. A recovery balloon will be dropped at that point. Helium will be pumped into the balloon to inflate it. The process takes about 20 minutes. Once it's complete, the gunship's arm will latch onto the balloon and pull it up.
The fully surfaced air recovery system. I'm familiar with the theory.
Take it easy. It's been combat proof.
Do you think Sokolov is up to it?
The shock will be less than during a parachute jump, and the arm can handle up to 500 pounds.
So you're planning on going over the border in a single combat talon?
She's equipped with 2 6-barrel 20mm Vulcan cannons, as well as 2 40mm machine guns.
Sounds like she could hold her own against a battalion of tanks.
Even with the fuel in the reserve tank, we're facing a 4-hour time limit. If all goes well, it shouldn't take more than a few hours.
Home in time for dinner.
But if anything goes wrong, you'll be eating dinner, breakfast, and all the rest of your meals in the jungle.